Perhaps the most well-known GIS operation is to identify whether a point object lies inside or outside of a given polygon. This is called a point in polygon operation. In this example, there are three source datasets: a vector line dataset, parcel boundaries in AutoCAD DWG format; a vector point dataset, representing city-owned properties in shapefile format; and a non-spatial Excel spreadsheet representing public artworks. We wish to use this data to find works of art located on city properties and write this as a HTML report. The GIS operations we'll carry out include two point-in-polygon operations. Here I start FME Workbench with an empty canvas. I add a reader to read the Esri shapefile point dataset representing city-owned properties. I again add a reader, this time to read the AutoCAD DWG dataset of property boundaries. The first transform to add is an area builder. It will convert the property boundaries from lines into polygons. Now I add a point on area overlayer transformer. The city properties point features are connected to its point input port, and the newly built property polygons are connected to its area port. The point on area overlayer copies attributes from point features onto polygon features, and vice versa, where a point falls inside that polygon. But to assess if an overlap has taken place, we need to check an attribute that recorded how many overlaps occurred. I add a tester transform to the workspace, connected to the point and area overlayer, area output port. Opening the parameters dialog, I set up a condition to test for where overlaps is greater than or equal to 1. This will test the property boundary area features and filter the ones that overlap the point feature, and are therefore a city-owned property. For a third time, I add a new reader. This time it is the Excel spreadsheet of artwork. I open the parameters dialog and see there are several sheets in this dataset, and each includes a longitude and latitude column that FME identifies as X and Y coordinates. Now I select the workflow option, Single Merged Feature Type. This will ensure that all sheets are represented by a single object in the workspace. Because the artwork coordinates are latitude and longitude, I add a reprojector transformer to the canvas and set it up to reproject from latlong 83 to UTM 83-10. Here I add a second point on area overlayer, this time to overlay artworks onto the city properties. So the reprojected artwork features are the points, and the city properties are the areas. The first point and area overlayer was an overlap with only one result. A property either belonged to the city, or it didn't. However, the second point and area overlayer can have multiple results, because there might be multiple artworks on a single site. So for that reason, I open the parameters dialog for the second point and area overlayer, and under attribute accumulation, check the box labeled Generate List, and enter a list name such as Art List. This will cause the artworks for a particular property to be saved as an FME list attribute called Art List. A second tester transformer, a duplicate of the first one, again tests for overlaps. I connect an inspector to view those features that pass, and run the workspace. The result will be a set of 42 polygons, each of which contains public art and has a list of those artworks attached. An FME list is a way to have multiple values for a single attribute. Unfortunately, not many formats support writing such an attribute natively. I need to do something with these values, and one way to do this is to explode the list, turn it from one feature with multiple values into multiple features, each with one value. I replace the inspector with the list exploder transformer. Open the parameters dialog, and under the list attribute parameter, set art list. To write a HTML document, I first add a HTML report generator transformer. This transformer will generate HTML content, and I want to set it up to create a report where each property is shown with a list of the artworks that belong to it. Firstly, I set the group by parameter to property to create a separate report for each property. Secondly, under page contents, I add a header and choose the address as the attribute whose contents supply that header. The header level I set to H3. Underneath the header, I add a new page content of type list. For the settings, I choose the title attribute under the list item content and click OK to close the dialog. Finally, I add a HTML format writer. This will write out the HTML that the previous transformer generated. I rerun the workspace, locate the HTML file that has been written, and open it in a web browser. I find a list of city-owned properties with a list of public artworks that are located in it. Alternative transformers to the point and area overlayer are the spatial filter, feature reader, and clipper. Alternative methods of handling a list are to concatenate the values into a single attribute with the list concatenator, copy each value to a separate attribute with the attribute manager, or write the data and values to separate database tables with a lookup table to join the two. I hope you found this video tutorial useful. Thank you for watching.